Hiya, babe. Say, how about... Ouch!
Does that answer your question, buddy?
The Adventures of Maisie, starring Ann Sothern. You all remember Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer's famous Maisie picture. Now, in just a moment, you'll hear Maisie in Radio, starring the same glamorous star you all went to see and loved on the screen, Ann Sothern. But first, your announcer. Here's Ann Sothern as Maisie.
Yep, I'm Maisie, like the man said. Maisie Ravier. I was born in Brooklyn in 1900 and... Well, I was born in Brooklyn. You know, there's an old saying that clothes make the man. But I got a little story that proves that clothes also make the woman, if you know what I mean. It all started back in London, England. I'd gone over there with a musical review called Humpty Dumpty. Well, if you think Humpty Dumpty fell off a wall, you should have seen our flop. So there I was, stranded in London, and broke as usual. Luckily, I managed to get a job as a model at one of them hoity-toity dress saloons. Salons that catered strictly to women born with silver spoons in their mouths. Well, one day, a couple of us mannequins were modeling gowns for one of them stuffy title dames.
And this Ladies 5 is a creation of which Turnbull and Company is especially proud. I should like to call your ladyship's attention to the plunging neckline.
I shouldn't think it would be necessary to call anyone's attention to the neckline, Mr. Turnbull. Plunging, indeed. Looks to me as if it were torpedoed. Remove it from my sight at once.
Oh, but your ladyship, this is an exact replica of what has been worn in America.
Mr. Turnbull, what is considered quite the thing in the colonies does not interest me in the least. Remember, I am an Englishwoman, not an Indian. And if you have nothing more suitable to show me, I'll
We do, your ladyship. We've just scads and scads and scads of the very latest, the very, very, very latest. Next, please. Come on, come on, come on now.
But while the next model paraded in front of her royal hastiness, I peeked through the curtains to get a closer look.
And this gown, your ladyship, we consider poetry. Sheer poetry.
I consider it waste, sheer waste. Kindly remove it from my sight.
Yes, your ladyship. At once.
Nothing seemed to please this warmed-over Yorkshire pudding. Her reaction to each gown model was the same. One nostril went up like she was trying to smell something, and the other one looked like she had just smelled it. Too bad, too, because she was young and beautiful.
Next, please. Miss Rivera. Her ladyship is waiting.
Oh, coming, Mr. Tanville, coming.
Ah, your ladyship. Here we have the very ultimate in gowns pour la danse. Chic, revealing, and exercises a certain restraint.
I should like to examine it a bit closer. Come here, girl.
Oh, sure, Lady Smith.
If you don't mind, girl, my name is not Smith. It is Lady Smythe.
Oh, sorry, forgive me. Forgive me, Lady Smythe.
Miss Rivera, if you don't mind, I believe her ladyship would like to see the back.
Oh, righto.
There you are, Lady Smythe. Ah, oh, I see you are impressed.
Nauseated is more descriptive of my reaction, Mr. Turnbull.
Nauseated.
That gown leaves hardly anything to the imagination.
But your ladyship, after all, an evening gown is your...
Is like a picket fence. It's supposed to protect the property and not obstruct the view.
Yes. Very well put, Miss Rivera. Very well indeed. Don't you think so, your ladyship?
If you really want to know the vulgarity of this person herself...
A little fur chapeau also comes with it.
Yes, your ladyship, and it's just your type, too. Skunk.
Well, I've never been so insulted in all my life.
Well, maybe you should be, dearie, so you'll know how it feels to take it instead of just dishing it out.
Miss Rivera?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.